died when she was 48 years old. Like, I just, I've always made good money. I've never had to worry about how I'm going to pay my bills or anything else. I thought I had a big fucking ass on my chest. Cancer's got her way of really, I don't play no favorites, man. Nobody's immune.
So you're a veteran. Can you tell us the story about jump school and how you got into it?
I joined the service in 82. I had to pass a GED test, which meant I wasn't a high school diploma, so I had to join a combat MOS. So I thought, hey, why not get in even better shape? My recruiter was pushing the airborne option, and I just went for it. You know, I said, hey, you know, I ain't scared of nothing. I'll do whatever I gotta do. It was actually, service life was not too bad, really. I mean, looking back on it, I didn't enjoy my time overseas at all, but stateside was all good.
And you're telling me that this house is worth like $200,000, and then you lost this house. What was the story behind that? When you got your diagnosis?
I had to start my chemo and radiation, and I didn't have health coverage. I had no way to get it once I was diagnosed. So it's basically, it's like, hey, do you want to die or do you want to try and survive? And survival mode kicks in. Material things don't mean nothing when you're, you know, it's life or death. But, I mean, that's basically all I got to say.
All right. I have one last question for you. Thank you so much for your time. So, you see people walk by every day. You have such an interesting life story. You've suffered so much. And none of it's been your fault. You know, like this diagnosis, this service, like your wife dying. So my question to you is, if we as all people are to love each other in universal brotherhood, connection and unity, like the person you love most on this earth, why can't we all love each other that much? What prevents us from doing it, and how can we get there?
There's a lot of hate in the world. There's a lot of hate. There's a lot of prejudice. There's a lot of backstabbing. Everybody's got this me first attitude. And, I've never been like that. I've always put other people ahead of myself. I had to leave my loved ones and my family and everybody else to come out here to try and prolong my life. So that's why I'm here. The air quality. Back home we have red air quality days, right? I can't even breathe the outside air. So I'm a prisoner in my own home. With furnace, HEPA filter, AC. There's just no way to live. That's all I got.
Bobby, thanks so much for your time, man.